In this video, we will discuss about impacted canines, both maxillary and mandibular. This is the content list. We have to discuss incidence, etiology, classification, indications, evaluation and localization, and management. Signs. Clinically, what you can see when there is impacted canine. The first one is, if there is delayed eruption of the canine. Normal eruption timing of the canine, it could be maxillary or mandible, is 11 to 13 years. Right? So, if there is delayed eruption or prolonged retention of the primary canine, that means if the primary canine is retained beyond the 14 to 15 years, then you can suspect there is impacted canine. Otherwise, the absence of normal labial bulge. You can see in the normal individual, there is labial bulge by 12 years. 12 years, you can see the bulge of the canine, right? If there is absence of the labial bulge or the bulge is present on the palatal side, then in those cases, you may suspect the impact. There are 5 treatment options. First one is no treatment except monitoring. This is indicated when the canine position is tension. So, canine crown, impacted canine crown is coronal to the mucogingival junction, and if there is adequate presence of keratinized gingiva, that means attached gingiva. In this case, you will go for simple exposure by gingivectomy. That means, we will take cruciform incision. That means, X-shaped incision in the estimated position of the canine. Like this. This is the cruciform incision. So, with this incision, we will do incisions. That is, gingival sulcus incisions. Like this. This is the crevicular incision. And you have to incorporate the releasing incisions. This is anterior releasing incision and this is posterior releasing incisions along with the crevicular incisions, right? So, this is the incision designed for maxillary canine which is located low in the buccal vestibule. Now, we will see which is located high in the buccal vestibule. In this case, there is no need to go for crevicular incisions. You can take a semilunar incisions like this. You can take semilunar incision in the buccal vestibule. You have to maintain the attached gingiva. You have to maintain the attached gingiva. Then you can take the semilunar incision in the buccal vestibule like this. And you can elevate the flap. Right? And this is the incision design. When the maxillary canine is located on the palatal side. Right? So, say if it is located on the right side of the palate. In this case, this is the maxillary canine crown, right? So,